Emily. Today, I will bring you guys to meet my friends, and they were talking about the taboo and education of Iban.
Hi, Joanne.
Hi, Michelle. How was your doing? I heard that you just came back from Sarawak, right? How was your trip?
Yeah, it's really interesting. And you know what? I even learned the taboos of Iban people from our tour guide as well.
Taboos? What's taboo?
Oh, let me explain to you. Taboo is a restriction and prohibition against a particular activity. Iban people believe that breaking is a taboo is extremely objectionable.
So it's like pandang larang in Malaysia, right?
Yeah, you are right. So do you want to hear some stories about the taboos of Iban?
Yes, please.
Let me think about it. Yeah, there's a supernatural job called the headhunters in Sarawak. The headhunters will cut off their enemy head and hang them around their house. Iban people believe that hanging the head in their house is a sign of braveness. And Iban people will also serve the head with food and rituals.
Oh, is there any taboos you want to share to me?
Yeah, there's another one. Iban people believe that if burung nandak fly over from the right side to the left side of the road, it indicates that they will have a very bad harvest. However, if burung nandak fly over when Iban people are fishing and hunting, this indicates that they will gain a full basket of fish and meat.
Wow, I don't even know that Iban got this kind of taboo. It makes me recall what my Sarawak friends told me about the Iban people taboos.
Oh, what taboos do you know about that?
Do you ever heard the taboos for pregnancy and birth?
No.
Let me bring more detail about that. Oh my god! It's not allowed to break an egg if it is done, you know?
Huh?
It means that your child will go blind. Oh my god, stop it! Pregnant women cannot slaughter any animals, you know? Because it may cause your child being deformed or suffering from a bleeding nose. Oh my god!
Wow, Joanne! There's really a lot of prohibition for pregnant lady in Iban.
That's why it's called Iban's taboo, ma. I still got one more taboo to share to you.
Oh, what's that?
It's a traditional name-naming procedure.
Oh, what procedure is that?
In the past, Iban people were not eager to name their children. When the children are still young, they normally call ulas. And they also call their close relatives come to their house.
Oh, why do they need to contact their close relatives?
So they can ask the relative to help them track and select the names of their grandparents.
Oh, so that means that the child name is according to their grandparents, right?
Yeah, but it should be according to their great-grandparents because they don't want them their children according to the unfortunately dead grandparents, such as those who are insane, commit suicide, or fall from a tree, or even caught by a crocodile.
Oh, so what's next?
They will roll a rice into a small piece and then put on the wooden board, and then the number of rice lump will be represented the number of names selected. And then they will allow a special food which called Manok Tawai to eat any rice lump which contains the natural name, and whichever names eaten by the Manok Tawai will be the child's name.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, it's like that one. So it's a special taboo.
Yeah, it's really special.
Hey, Nahira.
Hi.
The other day I was doing a research about the education and religion for the Iban tribe.
Mm-hmm.
And it says that the Iban official religion involves worshipping and honoring at least four categories of beings, which is Kotara, the supreme god, and his seven deities.
Oh yeah, I have this one Iban friend. He told me about the Iban god in the sky realm. The first one is Singalang Murong, the ruler of spirit world. He is also the god of war. The second one is Selam Pandai. Selam Pandai is the creator of men. The third one is Andan. Andan is the god of justice. The fourth one is Rajamanang. Rajamanang is the healer. The fifth one is Bunsupatara. Bunsupatara is the highest priestess of supreme creative deity. The sixth one is Andamara. Andamara is the god of material wealth. And the last one is Simpulangana. Simpulangana is the owner of earth.
But nowadays, in the modern world, Christianity is a new branch of knowledge. Mm-hmm. And Christianity comes with Western education that seek employment and upgrade one's standard living to escape poverty.
Wow, that's interesting. Yeah. I'll Google it more for more information.
In conclusion, hope you guys enjoyed today's presentation and have an idea about the taboo education of Ibans. Next week, we will be discussing the economic activities and society structure about the Ibans. Thank you and goodbye!